So following the vagus, distally along the esophagus here, we see that the ventral branches from each side are going to come together to form the ventral vagal trunk. And then more caudally, the dorsal branches are coming together to form the dorsal vagal trunk. And so they go through the diaphragm as just the dorsal and ventral vagal trunk. That dorsal vagal trunk is going to give off a celiac branch, which is going to come down here and join what is basically the combination of the celiac ganglion over the celiac artery and the cranial mesenteric ganglion over the cranial mesenteric artery. So we refer to it as a celiaco-mesenteric ganglion here. Okay, so this is a sympathetic ganglion from the vagus that's parasympathetic. So it comes down here, not to synapse, but then to follow these vessels to their supply so that it can innervate these structures with parasympathetic. So our parasympathetic from our vagus is going to get all of the viscera up through our left colic flexure. Okay, so the sympathetic trunk, recall, here's the sympathetic trunk coming down through here. And we're going to have large branches coming off of it here, which are the major splanchnic nerves. And it continues down here and gives off some minor splanchnics. And these splanchnic nerves are going to come over and join in our celiacomesenteric ganglion to supply sympathetic to our viscera. Okay. We move more caudally. The sympathetic trunk kind of dives and buries itself a little bit, but we see these lumbar splanchnics coming off of it, and they're going to come back here, and here's our caudal mesenteric artery, and so we have a caudal mesenteric ganglion surrounding it. Okay, some of these nerves that are synapsing here are going to head on up this artery to supply the descending colon, but then we're going to have some that are going to be contained within these nerves here that are leaving the ganglia. These are the hypogastric nerves, and they're going to bring sympathetic innervation into the pelvis. Remember, the pelvis is going to be innervated parasympathetically by pelvic nerves, but this is how the sympathetic innervation gets back here. Okay, then our parasympathetic from the pelvic nerves are going to get up the rest of the descending colon in our pelvic viscera. And we will see these when we look at the pelvic arteries and nerves.